changes.
Hey, what's up everybody? Welcome into the Rockstar Flipper YouTube channel. And I didn't want to post this video until I had as many facts and as much information as possible. Today, here on February 4th, 2020, it's being reported, and it was initially reported by the Wall Street Journal, one of the biggest financial newspapers and publications in the world. Just about 3 or 4 hours ago, sometime around noon or 1 o'clock this afternoon, it's currently six when I'm recording this. And now it's being reported by everybody that the New York Stock Exchange owner Intercontinental Exchange, better known as ICE, I-C-E, not like that ICE, but that's their name. They own the New York Stock Exchange, has made an official takeover offer for eBay. Now, it does say they are not in formal negotiations for a deal, or even if they do make a formal written deal offer, that eBay would even accept it. However, I do want to put my opinion in here at the end. I'll link this story below. I'm going to zoom back on it. This is the Wall Street Journal, of course. Again, one of the biggest publications in the world. And I'll read you from their website, and you guys can check out the link below. The deal could value the online marketplace at more than $30 billion. So the current market value, EBITDA type thing for eBay, is around $28 billion. The reason for that number is eBay does about $10 to $11 billion in gross revenue a year. That's like their fees collected, store costs, all that stuff. And most of these high-tech companies like eBay and marketplaces can be valued anywhere from 2 to 3 times their revenue, so their gross revenue. So 2 times would put them at $22 billion. 3 times would put them at $33 billion, so 2.5, somewhere in the $28 billion range. However, to own a company like this, somebody that's buying them will have to pay a premium. So if they're valued at $28 billion, they're going to want $30, $32, $33 billion. And so that's what it's basically saying, they're worth more than $30 billion. Now, $20 billion of that, $22 billion, is the marketplace that you and I know. The other $10 to $12 billion is their classifieds, which is crazy because it brings in that much income. You wouldn't think that. Earlier this year, they sold StubHub, if you guys didn't know, the ticket company, for, I think, $4 billion. Their shares are up 8.78% on the stock market today with the announcement that there could be a buyout. They've approached eBay in the past, and they did it again now, so apparently this has happened before, which kind of puts us at 50-50 whether eBay will negotiate it. Now, previously when they made offers, eBay wasn't in the same situation that they're in now. The losses to Amazon have mounted, no CEO, the eBay marketplace having a ton of issues in the last 24 to 48 months. All that has changed since, I'm sure, the last time they made offers. So this could be more enticing for eBay. ICE is primarily interested in owning eBay's core marketplace. That's where you and I sell. The classified unit could fetch around $10 billion in a sale. So that puts that eBay marketplace around $20 to $22 billion. eBay shares obviously soared. It struggled to keep up with Amazon. We all know that. The company has sought to distance itself from its reputation as an online auction house as opposed to an electronic marketplace, as online auctions have fallen out of vogue. Right, 82% of all eBay transactions are buy it now, not auctions, because people want stuff now. They want it right now. And so Amazon delivers that. And so eBay has to keep up with that. Nobody wants to bid on something and wait 7 days to figure out if maybe they got it. They want to buy it and have it sent to the house. And that's it, right? Nobody wants auctions. Roughly a year ago, activist hedge fund Elliott Management and Starboard Value LP urged eBay to consider selling both StubHub and the classified. They did one, not the other. And that was some of the pressure that they received. And so as we keep scrolling down, we see that eBay's last week, they reported their earnings for Q4. They reported a declining profit. The shares lost 4.5%. So they're down, of course. Interim Chief Financial Officer Andrew Cringe said everything is a part of it. Asked if by an analyst of eBay's core business is part of the company's strategic review. Of course, they've got to get more customers shopping. They've got to change a lot. I'm curious what you guys think is the most important thing they could change to help the marketplace. If somebody buys eBay, what could they do differently to help eBay's customers, the sellers, the buyers, the marketplace, just everything as a whole? What can they do to fix eBay? What are the top, give me your top two things, top three things that you think that a new owner could do to fix eBay. You know, I don't think eBay is a disaster, but I also don't think eBay is at any level that it should be. I think it's a fantastic platform. It just has a lot of work to do like anything else. Acquiring eBay would be an unusual move for Atlanta-based ICE, which in its 20-year history is largely stuck to running marketplaces for financial instruments like stocks and derivatives rather than consumer goods sold on San Jose, California-based eBay's platform. So this would be a new venture for them, but I mean, how do you think they would do? I'm not sure. ICE has a history of buying underperforming trading platforms and making them more profitable. It slashed expenses at the New York Stock Exchange, makes more money. Through cross-border takeovers of rival market operators have gotten tougher due to the increasing consolidation of business and regulatory obstacles. This will have to go through the federal government, I'm certain. They explored a possible offer for the London Stock Exchange, but retreated. So they have some experience in this. And so if you got to talk to these people that own the New York Stock Exchange, Intercontinental Exchange, what would you tell them is the most important thing that eBay needs to fix? In order to fix the platform, in order to help buyers, to help sellers. Hopefully you guys can see this a little bit better. There it is. I'll just zoom out really slowly. There we go. So my phone can focus on that. All right. And so if it was me, I'm going to tell them that the three things I think they could absolutely fix. Number one is that they have to get best offers and accepting money and payment situation, this entire managed payment versus PayPal versus whole thing. They've got to get this all just in one set thing. They've got to get best offers to be accepted immediately and paid like Poshmark does. That's number one. Number two, they've got to stop with all of this, cross-promoting, promotion. Stop letting, you know, if I'm shopping on one item and I'm looking at somebody's item for $50 and then all of a sudden on the bottom of the page appears five other ones. Like, that's just going to create just havoc. Like, you know, that doesn't help a seller. All of a sudden, there's always going to be somebody with a cheaper price. It doesn't mean that they have better feedback or they're a better seller or their item's in better condition, but you're sitting there advertising this on the bottom of my listing. Like, that's like counterintuitive. That's almost like shooting yourself in the foot, conflict of interest, whatever you want to call it. Like, they've got to get this stuff in line. Get these search results, you know, the way that the search results work, the item specifics, key this, key that, keyword, blah, blah, blah. Just, I want to search for something and I want to find it. And that's it, right? Give me the list of everything. The search should be solely based on title and not a whole bunch of other stuff. If you know how to make a title and you search for it, just like I do on Google, those search words should show up in that listing, right? And then, you know, the long story short on the third thing I would really recommend, and it's something a lot of people do, you know, the returns and bad buyers versus bad sellers. I think eBay's taken a huge step towards that. I don't agree with the Poshmark no returns accepted. I think that's kind of bad business and buyers expect that. But at the same time, I don't think you can allow buyers to just take advantage of everything. I think a lot of time and effort has to be spent on actually manually reviewing these cases where buyers claim one thing, seller claims another. There's a receipt with the weight. There's clear pictures showing this, showing that. I really think they've got to spend more time making buyers and sellers happy and not just automating this process of, oh, he says it's bad, goodbye, or vice versa. The seller says he sent it to you, have a great day. I really think they have to fix that. So some things that they would have to work on, I don't know how much experience this company has in those terms, but we'll have to wait and see. Can't wait to hear what you guys have to say. But anyways, eBay looking more and more, just like I said, that it's certainly possible. I said it would be the end of this year to 2021, but it's looking like in the next 12 months, eBay, 18 months max, may be owned by someone besides eBay, a new company. So we'll see how it goes. My last point of that is don't be terrified. Don't be scared. It's a good thing for eBay, at least in my opinion, a new owner, a fresh outlook, somebody that can infuse cash into it, make it better, make it a bigger platform means more money for you. I really appreciate you guys watching. Thank you so much. Make sure you hit the subscribe button. Keep up with all the latest news from eBay, Amazon, Poshmark, and the world of reselling along with social media. And if you need continued help, I did discount and put up all my social media reselling videos and everything that you would need, including membership into our private group where you can network, learn, ask questions, get one-on-one help, figure out how to monetize a YouTube channel, how to sell your eBay and Posh stuff on Instagram and Facebook, all of that included. It's really really a steal of a deal, and it's linked below. It's 24 hours a day. You own the material for life, and you own your membership to the group for a year. So take advantage of that. Use the link below. If you have questions about it, rockstarflipper@gmail.com, or questions about anything you see on this channel or anything in the world of reselling, please send it to my email. I answer all of my own, and I'll be happy to take a look. Have a wonderful night, guys, and I'll see you next time.